Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the Golden Opportunities Coaching and Pro Wrestling Logic Wrestling channels. And, of course, this is Pro Wrestling Logic. We discuss pro wrestling, old school, new school, all points in between as often as we can. We've got over 2,200 audios available for your listening pleasure. They do about a six-minute review of the Bret Hart interview from Superstars from the weekend on this, the 13th of March, a couple of weeks before WrestleMania 10, and 13th of March, a pretty basic deal here. We go to Owen Hart and Chris Henrik as one of, if actually the opening match here. Not exactly a great match by any stretch of the imagination, but is what it is. As far as things go, Owen Hart defeating Jason Headings, actually, with the sharpshooter on this particular edition. Owen hits a dropkick that's really good to look at. Owen also hits a top rope maneuver, as it were. And, you know, it's a very basic series of maneuverings. Owen gets the sharpshooter, locks it in, and away we go in a meaningful way there. Razor Ramon defeating Reno Riggins. Razor's Edge, very basic match as well. Razor a couple of weeks, obviously, ahead of the upcoming wonder that is the ladder match, in my opinion, still to this day, all these years later, literally almost 30 years later, the best ladder match at a national level in pro wrestling history, because it actually told a story. I hate matches that are just spots. I think it's killed the business. I think the reason that there's only 1 million people to 2 million people watching wrestling now is we went to a spot-based style. Nobody wants to hear that because it's not popular, but it is what it is. Razor Ramon, though, managing to hit a couple of his signature spots, the overhead and then the top rope deal there, and ultimately we kind of get the Razor's Edge, 1, 2, 3, and away we go. Quebecers tag team champions out here next after the hype for WrestleMania coming. There is a kick me sign on the back of one of the opponents of the Quebecers as they are fighting the young men. That is a little, I guess you'd say, overly aggressive, assertive, whatever you want to call it. But is what it is as far as that is concerned. Tag team champions Quebecers defeating Rich Myers and Steve Smith. Backdrop, the Cannonball and the Quebecers getting a quick victory in relatively quick order, less than 3 minutes or so. They're, of course, the Quebecers going into the WrestleMania 10 match in a week with the Men on a Mission winning it via countout, if I remember correctly. We go to a WrestleMania hype report. And the Jim Cornette hype on Mr. Yokozuna and Mr. Fuji being talked about there. The unfairness of Yoko having to defend the championship twice is the main idea there. Bam Bam Bigelow managing to come at this facing off against an enhancement talent. About 3 minutes of a match there, and ultimately, phasing off against Tom a lot, and punch kick, big body slam, and the top rope diving headbutt in under 3 minutes there, going pretty forward into continuation of things. Randy Savage faces off against Ben Jordan. Savage gets caught with a couple of moves from Jordan. Nothing terribly wonderful to write home about, but Savage hits I guess you'd say the hot shot maneuver, and Savage again gets the body slam and the elbow ahead of the crush deal, and we will see Randy Savage take out Crush at WrestleMania 10. They hype an interview and they close on that note. We'll be back with more right after this.